support the youth.
Suspected allied democratic forces, ADF rebels, attacked Lhubiriha Secondary School in Kasese District on Friday, 16th June 2023, killed 42 people and abducted others. The school is located in Mpondwe at the border of Uganda and Democratic Republic of Congo.
Regarding the attack on Peter Hunter Secondary School in Uganda, also known as Lhubiriha Mpondwe Secondary School.
While presenting a statement to Parliament on the attack, the Minister of Defense and Veterans Affairs, Vincent Sempijja, reported that there was a late and inaccurate flow of intelligence which allowed ADF militants to sneak into Uganda.
By then, they had also split up and attempted. What we did is to organize the intelligence, because when they split up, and they start moving in small groups of two or one or two people, you have to use intelligence.
Sempijja hinted at the fact that there were some people who collaborated with ADF and some had been arrested.
And the 25 were captured and we have them in prison. When you capture them, you don't kill them. You put them in prison. This was a bigger and well-armed group that Lhubiriha, than that one of Lhubiriha, the recent Kasese group, which was less than 10.
According to the defense minister, Operation Shuja in eastern DR Congo has been a success, with over 500 terrorists killed, including other terrorists from groups like Al-Qaeda, Al-Shabaab, and Islamic State Central Africa Province, while over 50 have been captured. He noted that life has also returned to normal in the area and explained the latest attack as an isolated case.
Had we not deployed in time, the situation would have been worse. In this particular instance, a tunnel of speaker, this was an isolated one and it is highly regrettable. However, does not and will not deter our resolve and commitment to execute our constitutional mandate of defending the sovereignty.
However, his statement faced a lot of questions from legislators who are not convinced with the minister's submission. MPs wanted to hear the fate of the injured victims and those that lost their lives, which were not captured in the report.
You are allowed to hide statements that I share. So you come to Parliament to begin lying, and you want us to. You want us to. Students were butchered. Because you are butchered right now. Beat. Killed like goats being slaughtered right now.
Some legislators pointed at lapses in the security at the border, which might have helped a silent sneak into the country and cause havoc.
That UPDF consider deployment, serious deployment of ground. This is very serious right now. Our people would die badly. If you reach the site, you will be beaten.
It is a shame. Very shameful. If you can respond on issues of smuggled items, why can't you respond when it comes to issues of human life? Is this that the money is more important than the lives of the people?
It's upon the MP's discontent that the Speaker of Parliament, Anita Among, directed the Minister of Defense to go back and make a more comprehensive statement. The Speaker also directed the government to take charge of treatment of all injured victims of Kasese attack that are currently nursing wounds in different health facilities.
How ready are you to secure these children in the schools? These children should continue being at school, but you must provide security for them.
Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.